Hey everyone, my name is C and I'm an economics specialist. Today, I'm going to discuss comparative advantage. The textbook definition is someone has comparative advantage for producing a good over others if they can produce that good at a relatively lower opportunity cost. So what does that actually mean in plain English? It simply means doing what you do best while giving up less compared to others. When I was studying econ, I always got comparative advantage mixed up with other concepts like absolute advantage. I always learn better from concrete examples than textbook definitions, so I'm going to provide a fun example in plain English to hopefully illustrate what comparative advantage means and why it's such a powerful concept. Let's pretend that there are two countries. One is a huge country called Biglandia, and then there's a smaller country called Tinyton, and people in both countries love peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. So let's see how many sandwiches each country can produce. Since each country has a limited amount of resources and workers, each day they can either focus on making peanut butter or jelly, but not both. Since Biglandia is a huge country with lots of resources, they can make 20 tons of peanut butter and 20 tons of jelly per year. Tinyton, on the other hand, being smaller, they can only make 5 tons of peanut butter and 10 tons of jelly per year. So they aren't as good at making peanut butter as they are at making jelly. To keep it simple, let's assume that there are 300 working days in the year. That means each day, Biglandia can choose to either make 0.067 tons of peanut butter or jelly respectively. Tinyton can choose to make either 0.016 tons of peanut butter or 0.033 tons of jelly per day. If each country just works by themselves and assuming that they want to maximize how many sandwiches they can make, then at most Biglandia will dedicate 150 days each to making peanut butter and jelly so that they'll end up with 10 tons of sandwiches per year. Tinyton, on the other hand, because they don't make peanut butter as well as they make jelly, they're going to spend more of their days making peanut butter to even out the production of jelly. That means to maximize their sandwiches, they will have to spend 200 days making peanut butter and 100 days making jelly, resulting in 3.33 tons of sandwiches. But what happens if the two countries decide to specialize in what they make better relative to the other and then trade? How much peanut butter does each country have to give up when they make jelly, and vice versa? This is called opportunity cost. Take a moment for yourself and pause the video to see if you can calculate opportunity costs for each country. All right, let's calculate opportunity costs for each country and what they should do to maximize trade. Biglandia's opportunity cost of creating 1 ton of peanut butter is 1 ton of jelly, whereas Tinyton's opportunity cost of creating 1 ton of peanut butter is 2 tons of jelly. And Tinyton can focus more of their time making jelly because they are relatively better at doing so. Tinyton's opportunity cost of making 1 ton of jelly is 0.5 ton of peanut butter. But Biglandia's opportunity cost of making 1 ton of jelly is 1 ton of peanut butter. So Biglandia could spend 225 days making peanut butter, 75 days making jelly. This would give them 15 tons of peanut butter and 5 tons of jelly. Tinyton will spend all 300 days making jelly, giving them 10 tons of jelly. The two countries can then trade. They set a rate of 1.5 jellies for 1 peanut butter. Then Biglandia trades Tinyton 4 tons of their own peanut butter for 6 tons of jelly. This results in Biglandia getting 11 tons of sandwiches and Tinyton getting 4 tons of sandwiches. So, before trade, Biglandia only got 10 tons of sandwiches and Tinyton only got 3.33 tons of sandwiches. But after specializing and trading, Biglandia got 11 tons of sandwiches and Tinyton got 4 tons of sandwiches. So both countries are better off. A common mistake that many people make, and one that I definitely used to make, is mixing up comparative advantage with absolute advantage. Notice in this example, Biglandia can make both peanut butter and jelly better than Tinyton in a year. So Biglandia has the absolute advantage in making both. Yet, Tinyton still has the comparative advantage in making jelly. How is this possible? This is because each day Tinyton has a lower opportunity cost of making jelly than Biglandia. They only give up 0.5 ton of peanut butter to make 1 ton of jelly. Meanwhile, Biglandia has to give up 1 ton of peanut butter to make 1 ton of jelly. Similarly, Biglandia has a lower opportunity cost of making peanut butter than Tinyton. So even a big country like Bitlandia can benefit from trading with a small country like TinyTin. You can start to see why comparative advantage is such a powerful real-world concept. Countries around the world will specialize in what they can make, then trade so that everyone is better off. A country with great farmlands but not as much technology will specialize in agriculture, whereas a country with lots of technology but not as much great farmland will instead focus on making machines. Then, the two countries can trade with each other. They will both be better off than if they just isolated themselves and made everything they needed on their own. So, in conclusion, comparative advantage is simply doing what you do best while giving up less relative to others. Thanks for watching this video, and be sure to check out more concepts on Chegg. See ya!